the cervical vertebrae. Cervical vertebrae are 7 in number. These are convex forwards like the lumbar vertebrae. First, second and seventh are atypical, and third, fourth, fifth and sixth are typical in nature. Cervical vertebrae are characterized by the presence of a foramen in its transverse process. This foramen is called foramen transversarium. Typical cervical vertebra. The body is small, broad from side to side, with superior surface concave transversely. The anterior border is bevelled. Inferior surface is concavo-convex. The bevelled lateral borders form synovial joints with projecting lips of the next lower vertebra. The vertebral foramen is large and triangular. The spinal cord shows cervical enlargement from C4 level to T1 level. Pedicles are directed backwards and laterally. Laminae are narrow and small. The articular processes, both superior and inferior, are flat. Transverse process comprised of an anterior root, posterior root, which end in tubercles, and the tubercles are joined by a costo-transverse bar. The costal element, equivalent to the rib of a thoracic vertebra, is represented by anterior root, costo-transverse bar, and a posterior tubercle. The posterior root is the true transverse process. The spine is short and bifid. The attachments. The anterior longitudinal ligament is attached to upper and lower borders of the anterior surface of the body. Posterior longitudinal ligament is attached to the upper and lower borders of the posterior surface of the body. Posterior surface presents 2 to 4 foramina. For the exit of basivertebral veins, which bring the formed blood cells from bone marrow in the body of the vertebra. Upper and lower borders of anterior surface of laminae give attachment to ligamentum flava. Foramen transversarium of 6th to 1st cervical vertebra transmits the vertebral artery accompanying venous plexus and branch from inferior cervical sympathetic ganglia. Anterior tubercles of 3rd to 6th vertebrae give origin to scalenus anterior muscle. Posterior tubercles give origin to scalenus medius and levator scapulae. And lastly, the spine gives origin to true muscles of the back like interspinalis and semispinalis. The first cervical vertebra or the atlas vertebra. First cervical or atlas vertebra has no body. It comprises a short anterior arch, long posterior arch, a lateral mass, and a transverse process. Anterior arch shows a median anterior tubercle on its anterior aspect and an oval facet on its posterior aspect. The oval facet articulates with the dens of axis. Long posterior arch shows a median tubercle on its posterior surface. Upper surface behind the lateral mass shows a groove on each side where lies the vertebral artery. The lateral mass bears an obliquely directed elongated superior articular facet and a circular flat inferior articular facet. The superior facet forms the ellipsoid atlanto-occipital joint. Where movements of nodding or yes is performed. On the medial side of the lateral mass is a tubercle which gives attachment to the transverse ligament. The long transverse process projects laterally. Attachments. The anterior tubercle gives attachment to upper end of the anterior longitudinal ligament. Upper border of anterior arch gives attachment to anterior atlanto-occipital membrane. The posterior tubercle gives attachment to ligamentum nuci in the median plane. The groove on the posterior arch of atlas contains the third part of occipital artery. This is the area of suboccipital triangle. Artery enters here from foramen transversarium of first cervical vertebra. The second part of artery runs in the foramen transversarium from sixth to the first cervical vertebra. And it enters the foramen magnum as the fourth part of the artery. Lastly, the first part of the artery lies in the neck below the sixth cervical vertebra. The vertebral artery is separated from the bone by the first cervical nerve. To the tubercles on the medial sides of lateral mass of atlas is attached the transverse ligament of atlas. The transverse process gives attachment to some muscles of the suboccipital triangle. Second cervical vertebra. The second cervical vertebra or axis has a characteristic dense or odontoid process projecting upwards from the body. Dens is fused with the superior surface of the body. Dens articulates anteriorly with the oval facet on posterior surface of anterior arch of atlas. Posteriorly it articulates with the transverse ligament of atlas attached to medial aspect of lateral masses. Superior vertebral notch is shallow. The superior vertebral notch is shallow, while the inferior vertebral notch is deep. Transverse processes are very small. The spine is large and thick. Attachments. The apex of dens gives attachment to the apical ligament of the dens. At sides of the dens, there is attachment of the alar ligament. Anterior surface of body gives attachment to anterior longitudinal ligament. Posterior surface of body gives attachment to posterior longitudinal ligament, membrana tectoria, and vertical band of the cruciate ligament. The laminae gives attachment to ligamentum flava. Transverse process gives attachment to a muscle, the levator scapulae, and the spine gives attachment to the true muscles of the back. The seventh cervical vertebra. This vertebra has long spinous process and is called vertebra prominens. Spine is thick but is not bifid. Transverse processes are larger. Tip of the spine gives attachment to ligamentum nuchi and muscles of the back. The transverse process contains foramen transversarium, but only accessory vertebral vein passes. The vertebral artery does not pass through the foramen transversarium of 7th cervical vertebra. Posterior tubercle gives attachment to suprapleural membrane. The anterior root may be long to form the cervical rib.